Welcome at the first Shopware Digital Community Day from my side. You all might be excited to hear some news about our enterprise roadmap, and this is basically the topic of my talk, Enterprise, the Next Generation. My agenda for today, first, I will show you what we're currently working on. I will continue with future projects, and at the end, I will show you our vision and ideas for the future. Let's start with our B2B suite. This is one of our well-known accelerators you know from Shopware 5, and our main task is currently finishing the migration process of all functionality from Shopware 5 to Shopware 6. One of the still open things is the offer module, where you can accept and decline offers from B2B customers in the administration and communicate with those customers. The second task will be a full store API integration, since you know Shopware 6 is an all API platform and our accelerators needs to support this functionality as well. And surely we will have a look at the documentation because it's important for us to improve the onboarding process of developers for the B2B suite. The second well-known accelerator is the enterprise search. And here too, we are still in the process of finishing the migration from Shopware 5 to Shopware 6. Two still open tasks are the content search, where you can place certain shopping experiences in search results and search for those content for this content from those shopping worlds, and the content marketing, where you can place promotions and banners and so on in search results too. The first newly planned accelerator is Publishing Workflows. It's still a working title, so it might be has another name at the end, but Publishing Workflows describes basically what it is. It's about content creation. The experience we gathered in recent projects showed us that there are many departments that take place in content creation, like the design department, a marketing department, a marketing manager, a sales department, and so on. And they all have in common that they already have existing workflows inside their companies, inside their departments, and our software needs to reflect those workflows to enable them to work with the workflows inside our software. Our solution to this will be some kind of workflow builder, where you can create custom status and bring them in a custom order, where you can link the transition between a status, like when you change from open to in progress to a certain user role, so only the marketing director can release a page and the marketing department can only change the status to in progress or to in review. The second thing will be the transitions itself can trigger some certain actions like sending mails or sending notifications. And you can define the directions if it's possible for a page to walk forwards or backwards through the workflow. And there are some kinds of special actions, like the release action, where some cache clearing will be done in the background, where some additional assignments to categories and so on will be done in the background. And there will be some kind of draft creation, where you create a completely new version of an already existing page without changing the live version of this page. To summarize this planned feature, Publishing Workflows, you will be enabled to build your own workflows inside our software. It's mainly for content publishing, and you can trigger the actions automatically. The second task is Performance Essentials. Not only we got a lot of feedback regarding content creation, we got a lot of feedback regarding performance. So we want to make sure the experience we gathered from those projects will be accessible for our community. And this will be done by creating a best practice documentation on how to cluster Shopware, a performance documentation for Shopware. It will be some kind of white paper where you find key results of Shopware performance to prove what is Shopware capable of. Like when you're going live, you want to know how many concurrent users can be in a shop, how many parallel shopping carts, and so on. And there will be a testing suite at the end where you can run a certain kind of software on your server before going live to make sure your server setup is capable of the task you're planning. Now I need to show you a disclaimer, because in the next slides, I will show you some suggestions. And those suggestions are based will be implemented based on your feedback. So it's important for us to get your feedback, to know what you want, and to know your feedback about our ideas. So be sure to contact us and give us your feedback. When talking about publishing workflows, we already thought about some more advanced features for it, like some kind of auto-deployment, where you can prepare your pages on a staging environment, and when releasing it, it will automatically deploy to your live system. So you can make sure that nothing on your live system will be changed while you create new pages, where you prepare new pages. We talked about more basic workflows for entities, like products, categories, and so on. Basically, everything could be possible that holds content. And the release itself could be behind some kind of automatism, like rule-based releases, where you can release a page when a certain time is reached, or a certain date is reached, or a certain turnover in the shop is reached. The next possible idea is multi-inventory. So we got a lot of feedback that there are complex enterprise scenarios, multiple store setups, dropshipping setups, setups with multiple merchants that might need a more complex scenario in the shopping cart, that might have some complex enterprise scenarios, and shopware needs to be capable of holding them. So there will be some kind of rule-based in-stock needed, where you can place your some kind of rule-based in-stock is needed, where someone from Germany might see another stock, like one from Berlin, like one from London, and so on. And there might be some more customized in-stock, like time slots for services, download keys, and so on. So our aim in this topic is making the shopping cart more open to complex enterprise scenarios. And we thought about some kind of split orders and multiple deliveries. This is also important for dropshipping setups, for setups with multiple merchants, marketplace scenarios. So an order might to be split up into different parts. If there are some merchants that take place in your shop where you can, where they offer their goods in your shop, and you order one product from merchant A and the second one from merchant B, the order might need to be split up in two different orders, and the shop customer might need to pay multiple times, because the merchant itself will be the one who gets the money. And there might be some split-based, some rule-based splitting of the order, like my example before. When you are from Berlin or from London, you might get two different deliveries, two different orders in the system. Now, the last slide of my presentation is also the most important part of my presentation, because it's about taking part in our development. As Josh, our product director, showed you before, we are working on some kind of idea management. And it's really important for us to get your feedback about our ideas, your feedback about what we need to do to make you happy with our software. So please be sure to take part in our development, to share your feedback with us, and help us to create the product you want. That was it from my side, and now we will go on with the Q&A session.